Are you tired of having to reply to different email messages from your inbox? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use AI to automatically automate any incoming message inside of your inbox. That is right, you heard it correctly. We are going to set up an automation that is going to monitor our Gmail account for any incoming email, and then it's going to use GPT to write a well-crafted reply to that email. Let me give you a quick overview of what we are going to be building. It is going to be something really simple that can be fine-tuned to your liking, improving this process, making it exactly fit your needs. We're going to be starting off by creating a trigger that is going to listen to any incoming messages inside of our inbox. After that, we are going to create a custom prompt that is going to be a good reply to pretty much any kind of email that we receive inside of our inbox. After that, we are going to start an approval. We are going to check the message that we have generated, and if we like this message, we are going to approve to send or a reply to that email. If we don't like that message, we're just going to send a message to ourselves, keeping track of the reply that we didn't like. Are you ready to automate your Gmail account? Let's dive right into this and see how it's done. We are going to be starting with an automated Cloudflow. Let's start from scratch, entirely from the beginning. We're going to call this automated Gmail. And the trigger that we're going to be searching for is going to be under Gmail, when a new email arrives. You can use this on your Outlook and on your business accounts as well. And also you can be as specific with this as you want. Let me show you exactly what I mean. Once we have created the first step, we have to connect our Gmail account. My Gmail account has already been created, and after that we have to set some settings. What kind of settings? So we don't want to filter maybe all of the different emails that are incoming. Maybe we just want to filter a few of the different emails that are incoming. In that case, I would use the to field to filter out only the emails that I want to select. And I can do the same for the form, for the subject, for the important, started, label, and so on. In addition to that, I can also check the different parameters that are going to monitor my inbox. So every 3 minutes, I'm going to check my inbox, see if there's any new emails that match this criteria. I'm going to reduce this to 1 minute, but we can also reduce it to less, to seconds, hours, days, weeks, and month. Also, we can set a specific time zone when we want to start the checking, or if we want to just check it once in a while. So what do we do next? Once we receive an email, we have to use GPT to reply to the body of that email. So let's search for AI Builder, and inside of AI Builder, we're going to have different functionalities. Let's see the one with GPT. Create text with GPT using a prompt. Let's use this one, and right here in the prompt, let's create a new custom prompt. So what do we want to do? I have created the following prompt. Let me read it to you. Give the HTML body of an email your tasks to generate a professional and personalized reply to address the following steps. Extract and interpret the main content from the HTML body of the email. Focus on key messages, questions, and action points. Determine the purpose of the email. Categorize the email as a request for information, etc. Identify key details such as dates. Analyze the tone and formality. Incorporate context about your professional background and current roles where relevant. Mention that you are an expert in process automation, RPA, intelligent automation, and so on. Generate a draft response that includes a polite greeting, clear and concise answers. If action is requested, outline the steps you take to suggest a course of action, and so on. Personalize the response by referencing any ongoing conversation or previous interaction. Conclude the email with a courteous sign-off, including a professional signature that mentions your current role as CEO of Pugliai and other relevant contact. Let me add my email here as well. Email. Now that we have a new template saved, we can insert a dynamic value. What is the dynamic value? A dynamic value is going to be, in this case, the body of the email to which we want to generate a reply following these instructions. I have showed you this prompt to show you how I have addressed this prompt. I have put the prompt into context. I have asked it specific instructions and specific output for the email, and I'm trying to be as precise as possible on who I am and how it could react and respond to just general emails. However, this is probably not the best use case, because the best use case would be, for example, client inquiries, renting an apartment, people are asking you questions about the apartment. So you would load here in this prompt or inside the dynamic variable, any or all of the information that you need. You would create your custom prompt, and that's how you would have in context all of the information that you want with dynamic variables. So let's add a dynamic variable. We're going to call it body of the email, and we're ready to save our prompt. Our prompt is ready and is going to require quite a little bit of fine tuning and playing around to get it to what we exactly want. But fortunately, in Power Automate, we have the ability to test our prompts inside of the configuration window that is taking extremely long to load. So right here in the test your prompt, we can input a sample of a email. Hey, how are you? And we could test our prompt and see what kind of output we would be expecting. So for example, right here, I am inputting the prompt as it is, and then I'm inputting this, how are you? Now, it would be good practice if I were to add some sort of delimiters or something to signal that this is the body of the email. So I could write body of email and then close it maybe with hashtags. And so I'm going to update this according to the default instructions. And this is going to signal, make it clear for the language model to understand that this is where we're going to be inserting our email. So let's test this prompt again, see if there is any changes in the output. To get a better prompt, meaning that all of the information here has been filtered out, and the answer is pretty good. Thank you for reaching out to me. I hope this email finds you well. I understand that you started your email with your greeting, how are you? It's great to hear from you, and I appreciate your friendly approach. Moving forward, I would like to address your questions, concerns, etc. It's a pretty good email or a prompt, so we can save this and let's on move to the next step. Once our prompt has been created, we'll have the ability to insert the dynamic content. Now, if we click on this lightning icon right here, we can have access to the dynamic variables that have been generated in this action that we created right here. So if we add the body right here, we're going to insert the body inside of our prompt. And that's pretty much it. Now we need to reply to this email. However, we can't just do this automatically. Why? Because right now, to use this functionality, you do need to have an approval after you use generate text with GPT. So let's add the next action. Next action is going to be to start a approval. We can go into the approvals tab and start and wait for an approval. Let's add this action right here. And inside of the approval, we are going to select approve or reject, and we're going to select first to respond in case we have multiple approvers. We can also select everyone must approve, but let's keep it simple to just one approver, that is going to be us. Now, to configure this, we have different options. Now, if you're using Gmail, different options are not going to work for you. What do I mean by different options? If you wanted to get your current account of your that is using Power Automate, you could just use an action that would allow you to get your account. So in Office 365, you could use the Get My Profile action. However, this action doesn't work with Gmail. Therefore, you can't use this action and many other actions as well. So this is the best way that I have figured out how to make this flow work while using Gmail. So let's forget about this action right here. If you're using Outlook, you should be using this, and then inside of the start and wait for approval, inside of the assigned to, you would add the email from your Get My Profile. In our case, we are not going to do it like that. We are going to do it in a different way. We are just going to write manually the email of the account that we are currently using, and we're going to give a title to this approval. Approve via email. We can also add dynamic values here, but it is out of the scope of this exercise. The next action is going to be a condition that is going to check if this approval has been approved or not. So we're going to add a control, and we're going to add a condition. The condition that if the approval is true, we're going to send an email. If the approval is false, we're going to just send an email to ourselves. So let's first add the condition for this. Inside of the start and wait for my approval, we're going to select the outcome. The outcome is equal to approve. Then we are going to move on and go to the true action. So now that our condition has been set up, let's add a final action that is going to add a reply to the email that we have received. So we're going to add a reply to email. In the ID of the email, we are going to go to the dynamic fields and go into the see more option and search for the message ID. Once we have the message ID, we can also configure other fields as well. And inside of the body, we are going to add the text that has been generated using GPT. And this is going to be the reply to the email. We're going to put any other fields like ourselves in CC or in BCC or any other information such as the subject and so on. Remember, we can have different prompts to generate different contents of the email, such as the subject, the text, and so on. Now that the true condition has been configured, let's add the false condition and add an action that is going to just send an email to ourselves. And that is it. Our flow is ready to be executed. To make sure that everything is working fine, we would save our flow. And if we don't get any errors, means that all of the different components that we have used inside of our flow are working perfectly. Now, once we have activated our flow, let me show you what is going to happen. Once your flow is running, you're going to be receiving different approvals. The different approvals are going to be shown in the approvals tab right here. So this is the approval for all of the different emails that I have just received. So if I click inside of one of these, I have the choice of approving or rejecting this. Now I can add more information to this. However, if I wanted to see my different flows that have been executed and that are waiting for approval, these are these right here. They're still running. They have been running for quite some time. Why? Because they're waiting for my approval. If I were to click inside of one of these, I would see where the process has stopped and what is going on. We can see that the email has arrived. The email from this person has arrived right here. And we can also see the email that has been generated right here. Dear Marriott, thank you for reaching out and considering our proposal. I appreciate your questions and would be happy to address them. Regarding the quote, I understand that you have some questions and would like to discuss further. I suggest scheduling a video call to clarify any doubts and provide you with the necessary information. Beautiful. Thank you so much, GPT, for saving me time on creating these emails. This is an amazing save of time. So right now, if I am satisfied with this email, I would approve this flow and reply to this. You can also set Microsoft Power Automate approvals on your cell phone. So even with just a click on your cell phone, you can just approve this. You can also create different buttons outside of Power Automate to help you with these approvals. But that is it, ladies and gentlemen. With just a few actions, we were able to create a very complex automation that is going to run forever on my inbox and reply to all of the different emails, allowing me to save countless hours of time writing different emails, or right now as I'm doing it, copying and copy and pasting them inside of ChatGPT to get an answer for myself. Thank you so much for watching, and if you're interested in other AI topics, don't forget to subscribe, because I make all kinds of videos that are about automation. So if you're interested in upskilling yourself and learning more about automation, leave me some comments, subscribe, and I will see you in the next automation video.